All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Troy Boisjoli, the CEO of Murchison Minerals. And Troy, it's always great to have you back. How are you?
Yeah, doing really well, Steve. Thanks for having me.
Awesome. Well, I know you've been waiting for a while and you're very excited to finally get back your first diamond drill result on the HPM project. First off, let's talk about the drill program itself and tell me a bit about the areas. You were looking at two areas in this drill program, right?
Yeah, you know, maybe I'll start with exploration as a whole from this summer on our HPM project. That's a nickel-copper-cobalt project in Quebec. Okay, and exploration had three phases: geophysics, prospecting, and diamond drilling. So the geophysics, we covered the remaining portion of the 650 square kilometer project with airborne EM or VTEM, yielding a number of really, really interesting targets and results. The next stage of the program was prospecting. Our prospecting was very successful in defining a number of new showings near surface, at surface, nickel sulfide showings at HPM along a trend reaching out from Barre de Fer. And then the diamond drilling focused on Barre de Fer itself, which is a zone of mineralization that has dimensions of about 315 meters on strike, about 295 meters depth, and about 150 meters wide that comes right to surface. And that's a high grade nickel bearing sulfide mineralization.
Okay, so you're pretty happy with this first diamond drill result?
Yeah, we were really happy. The whole intent of the program this summer, the diamond drilling, was to expand mineralization and delineate areas of mineralization within the zone. And that's exactly what we did. The first hole that we have assays back from here, Barre de Fer 2201, intersected two things that are really of note, okay? High grade mineralization very near surface. So 18 meters at a nickel equivalent grade of about 1.86% nickel equivalent, or to put that into the perspective of copper, that's about 5% copper equivalent. Okay. And that starts at about 90 meters. And then you go down footwall to that. The hole intersected about 70 meters or 69.9 meters of nickel mineralization disseminated through to massive sulfide mineralization at 0.68% nickel equivalent or copper equivalent. That's about 1.83% copper equivalent. And that intersection of the footwall, purely expansion. So the stuff of the shallow at about 90 meters extended mineralization down, the stuff footwall, that's 70 meters of mineralization, pure expansion work.
Now you're still obviously waiting for results back. You've got more coming from Barre de Fer, but also you've got some at Syrah as well.
That's right. So in total, we drilled 13 holes, 10 of which at Barre de Fer and 3 at Syrah. And Syrah is an exploration target directly adjacent to Barre de Fer. Yeah, looking forward, we, you know, as we're aware, we went forward with an XRF process in order to be able to, you know, one, continue our workflows internally and make sure we're advancing work internally in advance of lab results, but also to be able to communicate to the market these results. Assay results coming back align exceptionally well. We're very pleased with the results and how they correlate with the PXRF results. So, you know, step forward, moving forward here, number of holes that are coming back. This is the first one. We've got, you know, 12 holes remaining with assay results. And then that leads us forward into a maiden resource estimation process Q1 next year.
All right. Lots to come for sure. We look forward to more results. Troy, thanks very much. Congratulations on this first one.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it, Steve.
All right, there's Troy Boisjoli, the CEO of Murchison Minerals.